this video, I'm going to try to attempt to show you how to duplicate one of your USB sticks, whatever you have on your USB stick. So if you have a USB like this one, or, you know, whatever stick you have as USB, and the information that you have on it, you'd just like to have duplicated into another stick, well, hopefully this will help you. It's helped me tremendously. Now, the example I'm using is using Kodi TV, which is already programmed on this USB, which you can click on one of my other videos to figure out how to do that, or to find out how to do that, to program Kodi on a USB stick. So I have Kodi on this stick, and I want to duplicate it onto another blank stick right here. So it'll be all set up and everything when I'm done, which is a great thing. So now that I know I already had this one programmed, so I just plug that into my connection here. I'll unplug the other thing so I can plug this in. I'm trying to do it holding an iPhone, so bear with me. I can't see the connection. Okay, there we are. So now I just plug that into my laptop, and I'm going to duplicate it. So the first thing you need to do, of course, if you don't want to format, it'll pop up right away with this right here. It says, do you want to format that disk? Definitely I want to cancel there, because if I do, I will wipe what I already have on that disk, which is the Kodi programming. So I just cancel out of that for sure. Now, the software is the key. It's free software that I found on the net. You too can find it, and I'll put the link in the download link in the description below, as well as all these notes here I'll put in the description below this video, so you can follow them that way as well. The software to look for is called Image USB. That's Image USB, and again, the link below will take you to the site. It's presented to us freely by Passmark, and again, you'll see their site. And then when you click it, I already have it open on screen so you can notice it here, but this is the software that opens up. Now, I already have my stick, as mentioned, plugged in. The settings on this first should be this setting right here. If I can focus, it says create image from USB drive. So I have an image already on my USB stick, and so I want to check this right here first. Create image from USB drive. So we do that. And then we want to do this section here in the step 3, which is select the location for basically where we're going to put this image on our computer. Now I have mine under my users, and then I have it called right here. This particular one that I'm going to make, I have it called Kodi USB stick perp test, because my flash drive is purple and it's just a test, so that's where it's going to be on my computer. So just kind of note where you're putting it on your computer, and you can do so by browsing right here on the browse button to find out where you're putting it. So now we're going to create the image from the USB. We know where we're putting it. The next thing to do, which is actually the first step, but I'm kind of doing it this way, is to make sure we click refresh right here. By doing so, it'll ask you refreshing the drives, will clear current drives, and basically let you know what's plugged into your computer. So by doing so, now I see that USB drive that I just plugged into my computer. It's showing up right here, and of course I have to check the little box right here where it says E drive on mine. So when I check that, I'm saying, okay, use this drive for whatever I'm doing on the software, which we already have programmed, which is create image from that and store it right here on my computer. So now that it's all checked, very simple really, we just hit the create button right here. And by hitting create, I'm just taking it painstakingly slow here to try to get it across so we don't make any mistakes. We're creating from the USB image, whatever is on our USB at the moment. In my case, it's Kodi. And it's going to go right here, where we have it listed as whatever file name we put in. So I'm going to hit create and sit back. Oh, it'll pop up with these little messages. Basically, you would just hit yes here. And by doing so, You can see the status. It says USB unknown and status right here, creating. Now it's doing a, you know, taking its time, and it will take a little bit of time, not too bad, but I'll let it go here in real time, so you can fast forward the video if you don't want to just see this where it's creating basically whatever I had on the USB. It's creating it onto the hard drive. You can see the progress bar going right here, and I'm just going to let it run in real time, so this may take a little bit of time. So again, feel free to fast forward this video to where the file is created. Again, what we're doing, we have a USB already programmed with something. In my case, I have Kodi TV software programmed on my USB stick, and I want to make a duplicate so I can have another USB stick with my exact Kodi setup. So that's what I'm doing. I have my USB stick already programmed. It's in there now. And what I'm telling this software to do, which is free software, by the way, free, I'm telling this software to please make a duplicate for me on my hard drive, on my laptop. And then when it does that, what we're going to do is take that, what it's created on my laptop, and we're basically just going to use this same software and burn it right to a brand new USB flash drive. And then by doing so, we shall have a duplicate of my original. Now in my notes, if you're reading down through my notes below this video, I also mentioned that it's best to use 3.0 USB flash drives. They're much faster, much better. So that's one huge tip. Now you can use the 2.0, but they're so antagonizingly slow. So I'd recommend definitely using 3.0 USB flash drives. Also, another tip is what I found, at least in my case. Now yours, what you're doing may be a little different, but what I find with each of the flash drives, when you're making a duplicate, if you try duplicating, for instance, say a 16 gig USB flash drive onto another 16 gig USB flash drive, it doesn't always work properly because the first USB flash drive may have like a very small difference in the actual size. I'm finding that most USB sticks have a small variance in size, like with their bits or bytes or whatever, and then it gives you a problem when duplicating. So my recommendation, from my experience anyway, is to use an original USB disk that is smaller. Like for instance, the one I have plugged in here now, it's an 8 gig. And then when I go to make the duplicate on my other sticks, I'm going to use 16 or higher for every other USB flash drive that is going to be the duplicate. That way there's never a conflict because my original is always smaller and there's no kind of a conflict at all, ever. So I would recommend that to you as well. Again, we're just doing this in real time, so I'm kind of rambling with a few little hints and tips along the way. You see the progress bar moving along. You can feel free to go along in the video here, fast forward if you've even bothered to sit in real time listening here. You have good patience. This is doing it in real time. It's creating. Creating from my original USB drive. That's what it's doing. The status is creating it onto my hard drive of my laptop. And we're just waiting for this process to complete. And of course it has the status bar here as well telling me what it's doing. Along with, it's just the status bar, of course, just basically a reflection of this right here, the status of creating the USB. And we're just waiting in real time. Feel free to fast forward to closer to the end of the video where we'll actually have more information about the duplication of it, of the next USB. So I'm throwing in repetitive facts here. Starting with an original USB, or saving that information from that original USB onto my laptop. Once that saves, is what we're doing now, it's saving it to my laptop. Once that file saves, we will take that file and burn it onto a brand new USB stick. The original USB stick is a 8 gig, which I'm using, and the duplicates are going to be 16 gig, again, so that there's no conflict of size. I found it's always better to use an original that's smaller than the duplicate. You may find a different experience, I don't know, but this has been my experience. And again, the software that we're using is free software. It's called Image USB by Passmark Software. Free for download, and I'll include their link below this video as well, so you can find that. And these notes that I have right here, which seem to be partially blocked by, let me just move this over here a little bit. I'll have these notes listed below the video as well, which are basic steps that we're doing here now while we're waiting in real time for the file to be created on my hard drive. But these steps right here in the notepad, they will be listed below the video as well, so you can follow them. But it's pretty straightforward, it's pretty simple, and really it's only a couple of steps, or just a few steps really, just basic. I'm just rambling on for the video, and you can turn the sound down anytime so you don't have to listen to me ramble, and you can fast forward this video so you can get to where this bar is done. We're doing this in real time just to let you know how long it actually takes. That's the basis of doing it in real time, just to let you know how long it takes. I may do a condensed version of this and just show the actual you know, how it's all done without taking it in and watching it rather in real time. But for now, I'm just going to do this video in real time just to let you know, so you can kind of match up your experience with this video as well and understand that it does take a few minutes to do, and you're not off or wrong by realizing that it does take a little while to do. You can always check out my site as well, tvthat'sfree.com. And you can order various things there, including TV boxes that have the free TV on them. I don't sell Kodi by no means. I just sell the TV boxes, and then my service time. I account for that as well in what I sell. But the Kodi TV software is free, free for anyone. And it's highly recommended, world-renowned, in fact. And if you're just finding out about it now, you can go check them out as well. Kodi.tv, and you can download it for free yourself, put it on your laptop, put it on USBs, put it on TV boxes, whatever. Great software. Still waiting in real time. We're at 77, almost 78%. There we are, 78% now. Getting close to having this original stick burned onto the hard drive of my laptop, which we will, in turn, put it on another blank USB stick. This is how we duplicate a USB stick with whatever. Now, I have Kodi on my stick, as I mentioned, but you could have whatever on yours and just duplicate your information. Maybe it's something else that you'd like duplicated, and have maybe a drawer full of your USBs with the exact same information. Maybe if you lose one, then just pull another out of the drawer, and it's bit by bit, byte by byte, exact as what you had on the original, which is quite awesome, really. All thanks to the folks over there at Passmark Software for creating this Image USB software, and it's all for free, which is really amazing. Just waiting. Getting close to 90% here now, creating in the status. And watching the overall status bar. I'm holding an iPhone, so forgive me for all the moving and jiggling. Getting closer to the 100%, and then the status bar has to finalize a few things as well. feel free to check out tvthat'sfree.com. That's where I have a few things that you can take advantage of over there as well. In fact, if you don't want to create a USB stick yourself with Kodi on it, I can do it for you. If you head on over to tvthat'sfree.com, I can have one sent to you. The prices are all listed there. Pretty reasonable, I think, for sending all over North America for the most part. Same with the TV boxes. Some people just want to have it done. They don't want to set them up themselves. So I'll make it available at my site as well, tvthat'sfree.com. And you can order there the TV boxes with Kodi on them that I've already programmed and done. Also Fire TV sticks that I program as well. You can order them on my site. Okay, the status is now complete, but the status bar is still going because now it's verifying the software after it does its process. It does a verifying, which is always good, I guess. So now it's verifying the stick that all the information is there and in good order. So again, what we're doing, taking the information from my original USB stick, which is plugged in right here on my computer, and we're saving it to my local hard drive on my laptop. And then in turn, once this finishes here now with the software, we're going to take that file and burn it onto a new USB stick, which I have in my hand laid on the table here next to my computer. I was going to lay it in the picture, but I guess you can't really see it, so I'll lay it here on the table, still waiting in real time, just to let you know exactly how long this takes. That's why I'm doing it in real time. You can always fast forward, of course. I guess you're pretty bored if you're listening all the way through, but it's a good way to show you in real time how long this takes. Verifying at 41% there now. Status bar showing 3/4 of the way. Kodi TV is what I'm duplicating right now from my USB flash drive, so I can have a duplicate on another flash drive, and you can do the same, not just with the Kodi TV on a flash drive, but with anything you have on your flash drive. You want duplicates of whatever. Maybe you have some open source operating system on your flash drive already. You'd like to have a duplicate of that in case something ever happened to your information. Well, this is a great way to do it. Duplicate your operating system on your flash drive and lay it aside in a drawer somewhere. Every now and then, maybe just run a new duplicate so it keeps it updated for you. That's a good way for a backup. Bit by bit, byte by byte, exact. From my understanding, it's exact. It certainly seems exact when I use it, that's for sure. I never have any troubles with it. Again, using free software. Okay, verifying is almost at 100%. So once it verifies it here now, we have the file created from the original USB stick. And we're going to take that file and put it, okay, saying completed. So that's great. Now that this is completed, we just click OK right here, which we're going to do. And we can actually exit out of this software. Well, no, we're not. Scratch that. We're not going to exit out of the software. We're just going to change over what we did. So what we did, of course, is make the USB information onto our local hard drive, and we're going to take that file and put it on a USB. So what I'm going to do is take my new USB stick, which is right here. I'm going to plug that into this side over here, or wherever you want to plug it in on your drive, or your laptop, I should say. And in doing so, well, it pops up with my normal pop-up right here, which I just close out. If it happens on yours, you can close yours out. And what we're going to do is go to this button which says Refresh Drives. So I'm click on Refresh Drives. It says it's going to clear the status and put new stuff there, which it did. So now it's showing my new USB drive that I just plugged in, showing it as F drive, and saying it's basically a 16 gig, which shows a little less, but it's a 16 gig, and I had it labeled beforehand, but yours might just show blank under volume name and so on. But anyway, that's just when I refresh the drive, it just shows my new drive showing up there. Now, What we really want to do first for safeguarding is take out your original drive and just lay it aside, because we don't want to ruin that. I want to keep your information safe from that. And again, just go ahead and do the refresh drives right here, so only the ones you have plugged in will show. Click yes right there. So now by doing so, it just shows the one drive which I have plugged in, which is this one right here. And it's showing up here. So I want to check that box right there, put a little tick or check into it. So now my F drive, which is that new USB, is checked. And what I want to do now is uncheck what I had right here. And what I want to check now is the first one, which says write image to USB drive. It's the first one here, write image to USB drive. So that image that we just created, which if it's not showing up here, you need to go find it. You need to hit browse right here and go through your computer till you find what you just created. Now mine's already here because I know where it is. It's under my users, under my desktop, in a folder I had made, and then the file that I call it. So now I have mine ready to go. And then it's just a matter of hitting write right here. And when I click write, it's going to take the file I just created from the original and it's going to burn it onto my new USB drive. Of course, you get a pop-up. Just say yes to the pop-up. If I can find my mouse to say yes. And then I get another pop-up. It's saying going to erase it and put it on there. So you say yes again. And we wait for this status bar and things of that nature again. It's now writing the image we just created and putting it onto another USB stick. And again, I'm doing this in real time so you know exactly how long it takes, because it does take a little bit of time to do all this in real time, but it gives you an idea of exactly how long it's taking, minus the little bit of time that I'm taking for talking and in between showing things. I have an email popping up on my screen, so I'm trying to get rid of that. We're just waiting again now in real time, watching the progress bar as it burns the original image onto our new flash drive. And we can see right here it's climbing up with a status of 8%, 8.5%, and so on. So it gets up to 100% and the status bar goes all the way over. So we're waiting in real time. And again, now we're burning that original image from that original USB, the purple one we had plugged in, and we're putting it onto a new blank USB stick over here. So we're actually just duplicating. We're duplicating the original information on this, which in my case I had Kodi TV on this, an operating system on this, and when all is said and done, it's going to be duplicated onto this USB. Now this is all being done in real time here. That's why I'm just talking away while we're waiting for it to do in real time. Using the free software of Image USB by Passmark Software. And the link will be below this video. And all these instructions, not that there's a lot, but they'll be posted below this video as well. Again, we're waiting in real time. I'll probably make another video that won't be in real time, so it'll be even quicker again. You can fast forward this video at any time. When you see this scroll bar here, or not the scroll bar, but the progress bar, when you see it all the way over to the end, you'll know we're at the next point in this video where we show you it's basically completed. So we're just waiting in real time to show you how long this procedure takes. Now I'm just duplicating onto one USB stick here. Depending on how many USB ports you have on your laptop or computer, whatever you're using, like I'm using a laptop here, depending on how many USB ports you have, you can actually plug several blank USB sticks into your computer, and they'll all show up here where we have the one of mine right now called F drive. If you had more plugged into your system, they would show up here, and as long as they're all checked right here, a little check mark in them, they would all duplicate basically the same time. So you can duplicate, you know, two or three, depending on how many ports you have on your laptop, at the same time, which is kind of neat. Now, I did notice when I've done that a few times, when I have more than one duplicating at the same time, toward the end, when the first one finishes duplicating, because they're not always in sync perfectly duplicating, so after the first one finishes, the others may be trailing a little bit behind, and sometimes there's an error that pops up on screen. But I have found that I still just, you know, have a little patience and wait a little longer, and then I will exit out of the software even after the error, and I find that all the sticks have duplicated just fine. So I'm not sure what that error is, something to do with their software. I don't seem to ever really get that error when I'm just doing the one, but if I do more than one, I seem to get the error. But like I said, I just am patient with it. I let it sit there with an error for a little while just to make sure that it's all duplicated, and then I'll exit out of the software anyway, and I still find that they've all duplicated fine and well. So that's just another little note or tip or heads up or whatever you want to call it. But we're just doing one here now for demo purposes and showing you in real time. That's why I'm rambling on. Sorry if I'm bothering you rambling on. You could turn down your volume. You could fast forward. You see this progress bar? It should come over all the way here. So when you're fast forwarding your video, just look for that probably. Time it gets there, we should be pretty much done anyway. So according to my video stamp here now, we're at about 27 minutes roughly in real time. And it would probably take a little less than that. And of course, this is from a start to finish, from taking your original source, burning your original source onto your laptop, and then taking what you've burned and burning it onto a new USB stick. So we're doing the whole thing. Much of the time now, when you do this, of course, you'd already have your original already saved on your computer, so you're just having to do the second part of this, which is putting in your new blank USBs and doing the duplicate process from your original, which is already done and saved on your computer. So I guess you can cut the time in half once you do that first part. The duplicating part would only be probably, what, half this video time, if that makes sense what I'm saying. Getting close to 70% in writing the image that we created onto the new USB. Holding an iPhone here doing this, so again, forgive me for the shakiness. The original information that was on the purple USB stick right here, we have saved as a file on my laptop. And that file we are duplicating onto this USB stick. So in essence, we're taking this USB program, whatever's on it, duplicating that onto this one right here. And of course, if I had others and other room, I could have had them all plugged in, you know, and been duplicating this as well at the same time. We're waiting in real time now for the software to do all this. So the video is getting a little longer, but generally it wouldn't be this long because you'd have your original already saved on your laptop, as mentioned, and you'd just be doing the duplicate part, which would be probably half the length of this video. Which I think in my experience, when I'm dealing with 16 gig and my particular laptop, I guess all those factors matter, it's taken me about 20 minutes, 15 to 20 minutes to duplicate once I have the original file on my laptop. It takes me about 15 to 20 minutes, probably closer to 20. But we are doing the whole process here. So we took it from scratch with the original USB, and we showing you here how to put that onto your laptop as well, so it took even longer for this video. Like I said, I'll try to shorten up another video with just pertinent details, and put that one up as well. This is the real-time video of duplicating a USB stick. Check out my website anytime, tvthatsfree.com. Hopefully something there that can benefit you as well. I put Kodi TV, which is free software for anyone. I put it on TV boxes, and I just sell those boxes and my time of putting everything together. You can order that online. You can order USB sticks online that I have programmed with Kodi TV. Again, not selling Kodi TV at all, but just selling the USB sticks and my time to do it. But if you don't want to do it yourself, you can order them from my site, tvthatsfree.com, or you can do it yourself, of course. And I have some tutorials as well, which I'll probably have some links in this video pointing to where you can actually put an operating system or Kodi TV onto a flash drive. I'll try putting that link underneath this video as well. Now it's verifying my new drive right here. It's already burned the image actually, and the progress bar is not finished because it's doing the verification of it now, making sure that the image is intact and in good working order. So it does that. If you zoom in closer, you can see that's what it's doing there now under the status, verifying the image that it's already written to the new USB stick. Again, we're using the software that is free called Image USB. It's by Passmark Software, and I'll include their link where you can download it from. Thanks to those guys, tremendous software, and to have it free is just amazing. So you can use it for, I guess, your personal use, and that's what I'm doing here. Just using it for my personal use, and you too can use it for your personal use. Waiting in real time. Almost done. Well, climbing at 24% there now, verifying status. Progress bar almost at 3/4%. It's taking the image that we created from the original USB flash drive, and it's duplicating that image onto a new, fresh 16 gig USB drive. And everything that was on my USB drive will be showing exactly on the new duplicate, which is pretty neat. One thing which I did not mention, which I probably should have, is just an extra note, but it's kind of a neat thing to do, which I normally do. If I zoom in right here, you'll see it's grayed out now, but it says right here, extend partition. I really should have checked that, and I normally do, because my original was an 8 gig drive, and I'm putting it on the duplicate onto a 16 gig, so I would normally have that extend partition checked. So it basically, I guess, gives you the rest of the space usable on the 16 gig, whereas as I have it at this very present moment, it's going to basically copy 8 gigs over, I think, onto the 16 gig and turn that 16 into more or less an 8 gig. So that's a little tip there. I should have checked the extend partition, so then it would have opened up the rest of the USB drive for space. But I can still go back and you know, wipe this drive and do this again and do that. So that's the neat thing about it. I can go back and do it, but I would recommend doing that. In real time, from start to finish, using the original USB drive, burning that to hard drive, and now duplicating. In the duplicating process, we are at roughly 35 minutes into the video, roughly. Doing this in real time. Again, normally, once you have the original file already burned to the hard drive of your laptop, it's obviously only about half the time, so between 15 to 20 minutes, roughly, to make your duplications after you have your original burned onto your laptop. This is almost done. We're almost at 70% status here now of the duplicate being on the new drive. It's pretty cool stuff, I tell you. A lot of people want to know how they could duplicate. I know I've read in some of the comments people asking, well, it would be great, how could we make a duplicate of whatever it was on the USB stick, and in my case it's Kodi on the USB stick, and it would be great to make a duplicate for ourselves or whatever. And this is one way to do it, a great way, very easy. Just more or less, once you check the settings, the proper settings there in this software, you sit back and wait for it to do its thing. So there's no real effort as such. Verifying at 80% there now, a little over 81. And it's just verifying the image that was burned onto the new stick, which we have down here. Just waiting for this image to be burned onto it, which is a duplicate exactly of the original, which is pretty neat. Whatever you have on your original, maybe you have an operating system. Well, you can duplicate that onto another stick and lay it aside in a drawer somewhere. Say something happens to your original, pull out the one in your drawer, and there it is, all still intact. Everything that was on that original is mirrored right onto your new stick. Pretty cool. This is almost done here now. And then really it's just exiting out of the software and you're done. And that's it. My commentary may extend it a little longer, but in reality it's not much to it. Okay, now it's saying completed. We got the completed sign, so we're just going to click OK on that software right there. Click OK. And right here in the status it says completed, verifying passed. And you can see the status bar down here done all the way. So basically we're done. We're just going to exit out of the software now down here. So exit out. First I'm going to just open up my notepad with my notes there so my desktop don't show. But we're just on that software. I'm going to click exit and the software will disappear off my screen and I'm left with just my notes. And basically I'm done. So now this right here, this USB right here, I'm going to disconnect it from my computer. We're done. You can stop watching if you want. I'm just explaining it fully. Exiting out so now I can take off this out of my computer. Now, this USB stick right here, I'm going to lay it on top of my computer. This is an exact duplicate of the information that was originally on this. So I took this one originally, put it into my laptop. I burned this image using that USB image software. I burned this image onto my laptop, and then I took that image that was on my laptop and I burned it onto this. So now if I was to plug in this here and launch my operating system that I have on this, if I took it out completely and put this one in, it would show the exact same information that I have on this one. So there you have it, just that simple. Duplicating USB 6. Hope you enjoy. Thanks for tuning in.